Did you know there's a way to start a fire by squishing air? In this project, we're building a tool that does exactly that. And with a little bit of resourcefulness, we can make this for under a buck. The materials for this project cost me less than a dollar. I got these pieces of scrap acrylic for free, and besides those, all I'm going to need are a couple of rubber O-rings, a 1.5-inch bolt, and this handle I got off a lawnmower. This piece of clear acrylic rod fits perfectly into this tube, so I'm ready to form the piston. I'll use a 10-inch piece of rod and secure it into the chuck of my drill press. A hacksaw is my tool of choice for cutting a groove in the plastic rod, and with a bit of guesswork, I've made it just big enough to fit this O-ring securely, leaving the rubber edges slightly wider than the rod. Next, I'll place the rod in a bench vise protected with a terry cloth, and when it's secure, use a 3/16 drill bit to cut a hole right through the side. It's a clean cut, and the spacing is about 1/4 inch from the O-ring, so I'll proceed to my chop saw and make a cut just barely touching the top of the hole. This has just created a claw that will hold my tinder. It's time to cut these pieces to length, so I'll mark them at 6 inches and cut them together. While I'm here, I may as well cut an inch off the tubing and a small square piece that I'll use in a minute. Okay, I've got all my pieces cut to length, so now I'll remove the protective paper from this little square and carefully cement it to one end of the tubing. This will need to be an airtight seal, and I'm hoping this weight on top will help. With that setting, I can get back to making the piston. This time I'm using my drill press and a 1/4-inch bit to drill a hole down the inside of the rod. My goal is to get the hole as centered as I can, and when it's roughly 1 1/4 inches deep, it can be transferred back to my bench vise for tapping. This is a 5/16 coarse thread tap, and I'm using it because it matches the threads on this bolt. To make this handle, I carefully used my vise and a 1/2-inch drill bit to hollow out the center, which made a large cavity that I'll be using later. I threaded this hex bolt all the way in and then secured it tightly using a pair of pliers. You can see the handle and the rod thread perfectly together, and will just need to be tightened by hand. A little acrylic cement is applied to the rod near the handle, then the 1-inch piece of tubing is added and cemented in place by dripping glue into the gaps. This piece is to help reinforce the area where the handle meets the rod. That's setting, and it looks like the tubing is cured enough to knock down the base on my belt sander. Just a minute of sanding and the base is rounded and looking much better. To help it cure airtight, I'll clamp it together and leave it overnight. To finish off the piston, all I need to do is slide the other O-ring into place, and this will help cushion the acrylic pieces from impact with each other, as well as create a slight gap between the tinder claw and the chamber base. A little bit of lubrication is added to the O-ring, and this $1 fire piston is looking awesome. I even found a little cap that fits perfectly into the handle. I had enough material to make another piston. I'm going to test the small one first using some char cloth I made in a previous video. I don't need very much, and this little piece should work fine. When that's rolled up and placed in the grips of the tinder claw, I'll gently insert the rod into the chamber until the O-ring presses inside. Then with one swift downward stroke, I've got ignition, and my tinder is burning. I'll try that again. And this attempt was just as successful. By compressing the air quickly enough, the temperature shoots up hundreds of degrees Celsius in a fraction of a second, enough to ignite char cloth and other types of tinder into burning embers. The cavity in the piston handle is perfect for storing some char cloth, and the cap will hold it in place. To see if this will work out in the woods, I've readied a tinder bundle made from dry grass, and when my fuel is loaded, I'll give the piston a whack. There it is! I've instantly got a glowing ember, and using a piece of grass to transfer it into the nest works pretty well. The heat is building, and this little bundle almost explosively bursts into flames. That happened pretty fast, and before I burn myself, I better get this over to the fire pit. This bundle is a little damp, so I'm adding a piece of char cloth inside the nest to help it develop a flame. And there it is! And it's taking off fast. Yikes! I've been getting ignition on nearly every stroke, and this is proving to be an easy and fairly reliable way to start a fire without matches. Some people say this little tool was commonly used in the 1800s and was the inspiration behind the diesel engine. With this tube being completely see-through, it's exciting to witness the actual ignition point of my fuels. And for under $1, it was definitely a project worth the investment. That's another item for my emergency kit and a great way to see science in action. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.